What's up, everybody? It's another stupid thing I have to report. Well, today is July 25th, and 2020. Last year, I know I talked about it, but I was stuck with no car, no power, and, you know, really didn't have much to do, so I used to take walks, and then all of a sudden I started picking wildflowers and making wildflower bouquets. I just made two more. This one's kind of on its way out, but, like, you know, they're just pretty flowers. It's definitely on its way out, gone. But, I started doing it again because, you know, spring flowers, and, you know, why not? They're pretty, they smell good. It's nice to do. So, today I went along Thomas, which is the end of my street. I was picking some flowers along the edge of the road. I might have gone like a foot into the grass, but the town technically owns, I think it's definitely like 10 to 15, probably 10 to 12, something like that, feet from the curb side to inside the property. That's why, like, if people's water lines get, you know, burst or something from, like, there to there, the town is responsible for that, and you're only responsible for the rest of it. So, needless to say, I see Melissa, Ralph's daughter, whack job, cop collar, petty bitch, sitting at the end of the street, like, at the corner, just staring at me, and I'm like, oh my god, you gotta be fucking kidding me, this is not your property, and these are wildflowers, and I'm not hurting anything, nothing's planted, it's all wild. So, sat there, and then she creeps by my car and me, and I'm like, alright, the cops are on their way, I just know it. And get my flowers, and I come back to the house, and I make a bouquet, and I look out, and isn't there a Camillus cop pulling up? Are you fucking serious right now? So whoever the douchebag cop was, I don't remember him, but he was an asshole. He pretty much says, he questions me where, I have the video posted of the man, the conversation with the cop, because I will be recording every conversation with them from here on out. I should actually be contacting a civil lawyer. But anyways, he says, you know, okay, well, you know, do you like us coming here? And I'm like, what are you talking about? For one, there hasn't been a cop call in, like, months and months and months. Actually, the last one was when I got stuck at the end of the driveway, in the snow, and they called on me. I wasn't even, like, spinning my tires or anything, they just called because I was stuck to cause problems, probably hoping that my car is illegal or some stupid shit like that. And that was, like, November, December. And I'm like, it's town property, it's the side of the road. It's not in their yard. It's not touching their property. There's, like, grass like this. There's a gully, like a little drainage ditch. And then up top is where theirs starts. So stupid. So, he's like, well, just don't go over there. And I'm like, it's not illegal. There's no reason why I can't just pick flowers along the side of the road. I do it all the way up Belle Isle and all the way down here. And he's like, well, he knows. He pretty much acknowledged that he knows that it's not illegal. He knows that that's not their property. But just don't. Because why upset them? And I'm like, are you serious right now? I'm like, why aren't you telling them that them calling on me all the time is petty bullshit? And they're wasting your time. Like, instead telling me, you're not doing anything illegal, but just don't do it anymore. Because it could upset them. And then they'll call on you. You don't like seeing us all the time, right? Are you fucking serious? So I pretty much was like, are you fucking serious right now? I'm like, I'm not doing this. Walked inside, slammed the door. Done. I'm not going to deal with it. I'm not a criminal. I'm not a lawbreaker. I'm not someone that, like, you know, vandalizes or steals. I didn't steal power. Her father, last time I was without power, a year before, voluntarily brings me an extension cord and says, here, use this until your power's back on. Thank you, Ralph. So then Ralph ends up in hospice care, and little bitch over here thinks that she can be on a fucking power trip, power and control, and fucking just destroy somebody's life for no reason. That bitch, when she was with her ex-boyfriends, and she has freaking 2 or 3 daughters, she used to tell me when we were actually, like, cool with each other, how her power was getting shut off all the time, and blah, 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 she was broke, da, da, da. Oh, your power was getting shut off. Oh. Well, I don't have a daddy that works at Lockheed Martin to pay my bills. And that wasn't up to you. It was up to your father. You haven't lived there in fucking forever, and the bill was in his name. I sure hope karma visits a lot of people. One in particular. Or at least that his emotions catch up to him someday. It's the coolest thing that's ever happened to me. I just gotta keep loving him. Because I'm a fucking idiot. So anyways, I just wanted to do an update on that. I should be working on my Further Down the Spiral soon, hopefully tonight. If people only knew how wrong they were about me. If he only knew. He'd punish himself forever. Alright, so I think that's it for now. I'm sure I'll remember some stuff. I mean, everybody's still crazy. I've met a few people that are completely fucking more insane than the other people that I knew. And I actually almost fucking put my hands on someone this week. The first time in my life, I actually almost, like, she's lucky she got out of my car when she did. That's all I gotta say. So, alright, I guess that's enough for right now. Open up. Especially.